one single gesture, he bashed his way into rock and roll mythology. His breakthrough took place at the railway yard, run by his roommate Marty.
The scene was large. So Pink really used to play. He had this thing of where he played, put his guitar like that. And he did this, and he went through the scene there. So he obviously thought, I'm looking a complete idiot here. So I'll turn it to my advantage. And he smashed the thing to bits. Now after the gig, he was really upset because he didn't have another guitar.
There's nothing like a good smashing guitar done by Townsend.
Anyway, the next week at the railway hotel was a great big crowd because word had spread about this thing, you know. And they're all waiting there for him to go.
Pete's gesture became a symbol for the Who and for millions of his generation. As the buzz grew, literally, in 1964, filmmakers Kit Lambert and his partner Chris Stanchion, they planned to make a film about it. Numbers had the music, the look, and the attitude.
When he went in, he said he thought it was a version of Hell, how hot it was and dark, and you know, they were a very loud band, and he said, I knew immediately this is the band I wanted to see.
A flamboyant Sven Dahl, Lambert's motto was, never let the music get in the way of the spectacle. Pete's never let the ceiling get in the way. Together, they blew the roof.